Welcome friends, today we are going to see the fourth experiment in your laboratory. It is performing the following operation in Word. Okay. First thing is, you will see how to open a Word document. You are having various method by which you can create a Word document. Now let us see what are those. First, do a right click on your desktop, go to new. And in the new, you are having a Microsoft Word document. Okay. Go to your desktop, right click on your mouse, then go to new. In new, you are having a drop down where which you can create a Microsoft Word document. This is first method. Okay. What is the other way to open your Word document? Go to start menu, right? Go to W series. Okay, we are having Word 2016. If you open that, your Word document will open. And again, in Word document, you are having various templates, right? You are having various templates. Now, I will select a plain document. Now, this is a way to open your Word document. This is a way to open your Word document. Your first topic is modifying layout of a paragraph. Modifying layout of a paragraph. For that, let me copy a paragraph. Now, I have created a paragraph in the Word document. Next, we will see what are the different ways by which this paragraph can be modified. First one is left alignment. First, select the paragraph. And if you select left alignment, you can see that it is all the things are aligned to the left side. Next one is center. Here, okay, in home tab, under home tab, you are having a section for paragraph through which you can change the alignment of your paragraph. Okay, the next one is center. The shortcut for center is Control E. The shortcut for center is Control E. Okay, now you can see that the paragraph is aligned to the center. Next, align the paragraph to the right. Okay, again the shortcut key for that is Control plus R. Control plus R. Now you can see that the paragraph is aligned to the right. Okay, left, center, right. Next one is justify. The shortcut for justify is Control J. The shortcut for justify is Control J. Right. Now you can see that now the paragraph is justified. Okay. It is aligned properly. These are the ways by which you can align your paragraph. This is your task number one. Next one is managing header, and the next one is managing footer. Next, we will see how to create a header or footer in a Word document. For that, go to your Insert tab. At the top side, you are having various tabs, right? Home, Insert, Design. Go to Insert tab. And in Insert tab, you are having Header and Footer section. You are having Header and Footer section. Select the header. Again, you are having various types of header, right? You are having various types of header. Select one. Now, header will give you the title for the document, right? Title for the document. This is way to insert your header. Header will be located at the top. Okay, header will be located at the top. Now, you can see that when you finish OK, you are having header. If you double click on it, you can edit it. Okay, you can edit it. Okay, next you will see how to insert your footer. Go to home, insert, go to header and footer, go to footer, right. Now let us select. Again, we are having various template for footer. Now this is page 1 and 1. Okay, footer will be located at the bottom of your page. Okay, now you can see that we have inserted header and footer for a Word document. Now you have inserted header and footer for your Word document, and if you double click on the footer, you can edit it. Okay. Again, if you double click on the header, you can edit it. Now, this is the way to create your header and footer in your Word document. Okay. The other way is directly go to the top of your Word document and double click. Okay. If you double click it, it will directly go to header and footer. Right. Once you finish your editing or editing, you can close the header and footer by using this button. By using the close button, you can close your header and footer. Okay. Now you have inserted a header or footer on your Word document, right? Double click on the top, you will get header or footer. If you double click on your bottom, you will get footer, right? If you double click on the top, you will get header. These are different ways by which you can insert a header or footer in a Word document. Okay. This is task number 2. Then the task number 3 is managing styles. Okay. Managing styles. Now let us change the font. Okay, here you are having various styles. Okay, can you see that? Here you are having various styles. To change it, you can see that these are default styles which are inbuilt in your Microsoft Word. These are default styles which are inbuilt in your Word, or you can have your custom style. Okay, select the Word and then go to change the font type. By changing the font type, and then you can change the size here. This is your font, this is your size. Okay, you can change the size. You can increase the size by using this button, right? And you can decrease the size. Okay. If you press this button, it will increase the size of your format font here. It will decrease the size of your font. The shortcut is Control plus left arrow. Here, the shortcut is Control plus right arrow. Control plus right arrow. Control plus left arrow. If you place your cursor on that icon, it will give you the shortcut. Okay. The next one is change uppercase. Okay, you are having various cases. Okay. Sentence case, lower case, upper case, sentence case means the first alphabet will be in upper, the remaining will be in lower. Okay, if you select lower, you can see that everything has turned into lower case. All the letters are now in lower case. If we change into sentence, the starting word will have upper case. Okay, the starting word will have uppercase. Next, uppercase means everything, the complete document will be in uppercase. Okay. Next, capitalize each word means all the starting letters of the words will be capital. All the starting letters of the word will be in capital letters. Okay. And toggle cases means the capital will be small, small letters will be capital. Okay. For that, capital letters will be small, small letters will be capital. This is called as toggle case. Okay, these are the various styles which you can have. Then you can bold. Okay. Now let me change the font so that it will be easy for you. Right. Now if you apply bold, now you can see that these letters are bold. Again, what italic will do, it will give you a slight angle. Okay, select the word or select the letter and you can apply the same. Okay, then underline. Select the word and select the effect, underline. You can see that. And again, for a single word, you can have all three options: bold, italic, underline. See that it is bold, italic, and underline. Next, strike through. Okay, select a word. If you select strike through, means that word will be strike through. Okay, strike through. Next one is subscript. Okay, next one is subscript. It is used for typing your mathematical equation. X, for example, x2. Okay, after typing x2, select the 2 and select this option. Now you can see that now 2 is in subscript. Again, I will do it. First, type the word, that is x8. Okay, now it is still in subscript mode. Press escape to come out of the mode. Press escape to come out of the mode. Okay. Now you can see that the cursor is normal, right? Now type R, capital R 2. Now if you want the 2 to be subscript, select the word and enable this option. Okay, now you can see that it is subscript, and if you type it, everything will be subscript. Okay, in order to come out of the mode, go to a new place, it will come out. Or go to new, okay, or you can deselect this option. Okay, to deselect this subscript option, you will have your normal cursor. You will have your normal cursor. This is called as subscript. Next one is superscript. Next one is superscript W2. Okay, first type the word W2, then select 2. Okay, select the word 2 and then select the option superscript. Okay, you can see that the 2 has moved up. Okay. How to come out of this mode? You can deselect this selection, it will come out of the mode. Again, I will do it. T4. Okay, now select 4. Select the option superscript. How to come out of the selection? Go to a new location, it will come out, or deselect the selection. These are the ways by which you can change your subscript and superscript. Okay. Next one is you can change, or you can give your font different colors and styles. Okay. You can see that. You can, by using this button, you can change the font styles, right? You are having various styles, and then here you can change the color. By using this, you can highlight your word. Okay, and again I can change the color. This can be used for highlighting your word. Next, by using this button, I can change the color of your text. Okay, you can change the color of your text. First, select the text or word, then go to the option, then select a color. You can see that now this word color has changed. Now this word's color has changed. Okay, these are the various ways by which I can change the style of your Word document. Okay, I can change the style of your Word document. Next one is paragraph spacing. Okay, paragraph spacing. Now select the paragraph, and in the paragraph section, in home tab, in paragraph section, you are having your sizing. Okay, now the paragraph size is 1. Gapping between lines. gap between the lines. Then it is now it is 1.5. It is 1.5. Then 2.0. Then 2.5. By this way, I can increase the line spacing in a paragraph. I can increase the line spacing in a paragraph. You need to insert a graphical object into a word. You need to insert a graphical object into a word. You are having various objects, right? You can have a graph. You can draw a graph, right? Go to insert, shapes, select object, place it. Okay. How it is done? Go to insert, go to shapes, select a object, and then you can see that now the cursor is changed. Place it in the desired location. Okay. By this way, a object can be inserted and its format or alignment can be changed. Right. Its format or alignment can be changed by using this, and again its color can be changed, its effects can be changed. You can have 3D rotation like that. Then you can change the alignment of your text. Okay, this is one design. Okay, next let us again go to insert. If you want to insert a picture, go to insert and insert picture. Okay, go to insert and insert picture. Okay. Go to insert and insert picture, through which you can insert a photograph into Word. Okay, through which you can insert a photograph into Word. Go to insert and insert a picture. Okay, and select that. If you select the photograph, that will be inserted here. So this is a way to insert a photograph into your Word document. And again, this is by using the shapes, you can insert any shapes. Select the shapes, place your cursor on the desired location. Now the shape is created, right? Again, go to insert. Then you can have your smart hearts, right? You can have your smart hearts. Select the heart. Okay, now place it on the desired location. And now you can see that you have inserted an art in your Word document. Again, let us go to insert tab. Okay, next you can insert a chart. Okay, you can insert a chart. Then insert a chart. Select a template. Okay, select a template in which you want your charts. Then press OK. Now you can see that the chart is placed inside your Word document. Now if you give the values, if you give your x-axis and y-axis value, the chart will plot. Okay, let me change the value. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. For example, I am giving some values, right? Now, you have drawn a chart in Word. Okay, you have drawn a chart in Word. If you double click it, you can edit it. Okay, if you double click on the chart, you can edit the shapes or the types. Okay, you can change the design, and by using the edit data, by using the edit data, you can edit the data of the chart. You see that you are having Excel where if you change the value, the chart will change. Or you can see that the graph has changed. By this way, you can change, you can insert the chart, which is very, very easy for you. Okay, by this way you can insert chart, smart art, or shapes or picture in your Word document. You know how to delete a chart or anything? select it, press the delete key. Okay, how to delete a smart heart? Select it, press delete key, it will be deleted. How to delete this smart heart? Select it, press delete. How to delete a chart? Select the chart, press delete key. By this way, I can delete the inserted item. Okay, and again, photos can be inserted. Next, we will see how a table is inserted in Word document. Next, we will see how a table is inserted in Word document. Go to insert, select a table, right? Go to insert, select tables. Here you are specifying the number of rows and columns. Okay. This is one way of inserting your tables. The other way is, again go to insert, go to tables. Okay. Under that you are having insert table. Here you can specify your own tables. 40 by 20. Right. Here you can make your own custom tables. Again go to insert and under the table, under the table you are having draw table. Okay, what is the use of draw table? By using a button you can draw your own table. By using this option you can draw a table. You can separate the lines. This is another way of inserting a table in your Word document. This is another way of inserting a table in your Word document. We are having three ways: insert table, insert table, and draw table. Okay. These are three ways by which you can create table in Word document. Next, we will see how to insert a row, okay? Row or column in a table. Okay? Now, this is a table. Go to any specific location, do a right click. Go to a location, do a right click. Now, you are having, go to insert, do a right click, and then you are having go to insert. Go to a location on your table, do a right click, then go to insert. Insert column to the left. Now you can see that a column is added to the left. Again, select a location, do a right click, insert, insert a column to the right. Now you can see that a column is added to the right. Now again, go to a specific location, right click, insert, insert a row above. A row has been created. Again, insert a row below. Okay, a row has been created. Insert a row below. Insert a row above. Okay, by this way I can insert a row or column in either left or right. By either left or right, again go to insert, insert a cell. Okay, insert a cell here. That means it will insert a cell, right? That means it will insert a cell. Okay. Insert an entire row. Now you can see that an entire row has been recreated. Again, select, go to location, right click, go to insert, insert cell, insert an entire column. Now you can see that a new column has been created. Okay. Next, if you want to merge this column or merge this row, okay, you can merge a column or row. Okay, select the column, right click, okay, right click, you are having merge cells, right? First, what do you do? Select the column, do a right click, merge cells. Again, select a row, do a right click. Okay, after selecting the row, do a right click, and then you will have merge cell. You can see that all the rows are merged into a single component. All the rows are merged into a single component. By this way, you can merge a column or rows. Okay, or you can totally merge everything. Select everything, merge cell. Okay, now you can see that everything is merged. Okay, next one is cell splitting. Okay, cell splitting. Now select a cell, do a right click, split a cell. Okay, now you can see that two columns has been created. Two columns has been created. Again, select a cell, do a right click, go to split cell, select it. Now you can split a single cell into number of rows or column. By using this option, you can split a single cell into number of rows or option. Okay. And again in layout, you can change the paper size. In home tab, you are having layout tab, go to layout. Here you can change the size of your paper. Right. A4, A5, like that you can change size of your paper in layout. If you go to design, you can apply different design to your Word document, right? And apply different design to your Word document, right? These are various options which you are having in your Word.